Hi guys, this is the second video of the dynamic programming algorithms video series, in which we focus on how to code dynamic programming algorithms in Python. In the previous video, I talked about Fibonacci sequence and presented three different approaches to show how important writing an efficient code is. In this video, first I will give you some brief information about the short spread problem and then discuss how to code Dijkstra's algorithm in Python to solve this problem. To understand the short spread problem, let's consider a small undirected graph consisting of 6 nodes where node 0 is the source node. Each pair of two different nodes with some weight is called an edge. The weight of an edge can be distance, cost, or capacity depending on the problem. In our problem setting, it is the distance between the nodes of the corresponding pair. Our aim is to find the shortest path from source node to each node, where path is defined as a sequence of nodes. For example, all the possible paths from node 0 to node 3 are 03, 013, 023, even 0145 and 3. To find the length of each path, we sum the weights of the edges on the corresponding path. For instance, the length of path 03 is 2, while the length of path 013 is 1.5. And the lengths of the others are as follows. As you see, the shortest path from source node, node 0 in this case, to node 3 is 013 with the length of 1.5. To solve this problem for each node when the weights of the edges are non-negative, let me introduce you Dijkstra's algorithm. The algorithm basically applies the principle of optimality. That is, if path P is the shortest path from S to T, and if U and V are the nodes on path P, then the subpath of P from U to V is the shortest path from U to V. Similarly, the subpath of P from S to V is the shortest path from S to V. This principle indicates that to find the shortest path from source node to any node, it's enough to consider only adjusted nodes of that node. Now, before explaining the algorithm, here's some notation. S denotes the source node and WUV denotes the distance between nodes U and V. Also, DV denotes the length of the path from the source node to node V. The nodes are divided into two sets, permanent and temporary nodes. Permanent nodes correspond to the shortest path lengths, whereas temporary nodes correspond to the upper bounds on the shortest path lengths. In the first step of the algorithm, we mark all nodes as temporary. Then, we assign the path lengths to infinity for each node excluding the source node. For the source node, the path length is 0. In the second step, we first choose the temporary node with the smallest path length. Let's call this node U and mark U as permanent. Then, we update the path length for every temporary adjacent node to U as follows. This is the step where we use the principle of optimality, so the recursion. In the last step, we stop if there is no temporary node left. Otherwise, we go to step 2. Now, let's code this algorithm in Python by writing a function called Dijkstra. This function takes three inputs. The first input is the set of nodes, which is defined by nodes list. For our small problem, it is initialized as follows. The second input is the set of edges, which is defined by the edges dictionary, where keys are the node pairs and values are the distances. We can initialize edges as follows for our small problem. For the last input, we define source node by source index int with a default value of 0. As an output, Dijkstra function returns the shortest distance to each node from the source node. Let's now go over the algorithm. We first initialize the path length for each node by assigning it to infinity except the source node. Then we initialize adjacent nodes dictionary with keys being the nodes and values being another dictionary of the corresponding node. The keys of this subdictionary are the adjacent nodes of the corresponding node and the values are the distances between them. Here, how it looks like for our small problem. After initializing temporary nodes list with all the nodes, we iterate until there is no temporary node left. At each iteration, we first find the temporary node with the smallest path length, called U in our function, then remove U from the temporary nodes list. Lastly, we update the path length for each temporary adjacent node to U. While doing that, we use the recursion. So that's why it's a dynamic programming algorithm. I will talk more about this recursion step in the following videos while explaining other dynamic programming algorithms. I hope that this video was helpful. Please leave a comment if you have any question. In the next video of this dynamic programming video series, I will talk about Bellman-Ford algorithm for the shortest path problem. But this time, we will let edge weights to be negative numbers.